Hello, and welcome to the Rope Tackle in Shoreham. We're here to introduce you to Dice World. Brian Clegg is here to give you a talk on randomness. Have you ever wondered why when you flip a coin, maybe six, four, two times, you don't get an equal amount of heads and tails? Well, Brian is here to tell you why.
So we're talking about Dice World, and that is a book about randomness and probability and how it influences our lives and the universe as a whole. Really, if you look back to Isaac Newton, people thought of the universe as really almost like a clockwork mechanism. It was something where if you knew everything about what was going on, in principle, you could predict the future forever. So if you imagine sort of setting the universe off in its nice clockwork way, and if you knew how every atom moved and everything happened in the universe, in principle, you should be able to predict what would happen for the rest of time, which is a little bit worrying for matters like free will, but let's not worry too much about that.
Would you explain to me your understanding of randomness?
Randomness is a funny sort of thing. I guess you could say it's about things you can't predict in a normal way, and that there are almost two different sorts of randomness. There's a sort of randomness of the weather, where it is chaotic and you can suddenly get enormous storms, or similarly, the randomness of the stock market, where you can suddenly get a crash or something like that. And then there's the randomness of the sort of things that we've usually applied the term to, say, looking at things like, you know, the toss of a coin, or a roulette wheel, what happens in a physics experiment with an atom that's decaying or something like that. And there, although we can never say what's going to happen, so you can't say if a coin is going to be heads or tails, what you can say is there's a certain probability. But with the other sort of randomness, the chaotic randomness like the weather, we can't even do that. It will always take us by surprise at some point because there's going to be something enormous that happens that isn't predictable.
If you look at a quantum particle, something like an atom, an electron, a photon of light, these are all things that have probability as part of how they behave. If you think of an ordinary object as we think of them, like a tennis ball, and you throw a tennis ball, in theory you can calculate after a little while where it's going to be. If you send off an atom or an electron or whatever and wait a little while, you can't say where it's going to be. All you have is probability. In fact, it's arguable the electron doesn't really exist at this point. All there is a set of probabilities as to where it might be, and until you go out there and find it and measure it and find where it actually is, and these condense to an actual value, you just haven't got a clue apart from probabilities.
And can you explain déjà vu?
I've already explained it, don't you remember? No, in a sense, there are some biological explanations potentially of déjà vu. So some people have suggested that, for instance, there's more than one route in the brain. So you take in your surroundings visually, it's going into the brain in several different routes, and some of them take a little longer than others. And déjà vu might come out of as a delay between two routes. So whenever you're seeing things, it's really a construct. It's something your brain's making up. And that gives the opportunity for optical illusions to work, because that's why they fool us, because the eyes aren't showing us really what's there. And similarly, I suspect déjà vu is something like that, that it's just the gap between the brain's fictional picture of the world and what's really out there.
I wanted to ask you this one last question, which is, what's wrong with the statement that girls get better results as a result of attending single-sex schools when girls at single-sex schools get better results?
It's a bit of a tongue twister apart from anything else, isn't it? But what we're basically saying is it is true on the whole, statistically, that if you're a girl and you attend a single-sex school, you will on average do better than if you don't. But the argument is that's not necessarily the cause.
But thank you very much, and I hope you found it entertaining. Do we have any questions?